गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू। सो यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द इंडस्ट्रीज, ओके, एंड ऑल द नोट्स रिगार्डिंग इंडस्ट्री, ओके, लोकेशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज एंड अदर थिंग्स विच आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जामिनेशन। आई विल प्रोवाइड दैट, ओके। एंड आई होप कि वट एवर वी हैव डिस्कस यू ऑल हैव टू कीप इन माइंड, बिकॉज यू हैव टू नो अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट यू हैव टू लोकेट, ओके। सो यू कांट क्रैम ऑल द इंडस्ट्रीज, आप सभी को इंडस्ट्रीज को लोकेशन को आप क्रैम नहीं कर सकते। फर्स्ट वॉट यू हैव टू डू, जस्ट यू हैव टू डेवलप योर कंसेप्ट कि दिस इज फॉर टूज इंडस्ट्रीज और दिस और विच टाइप ऑफ इंडस्ट्री इज दैट। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट यू हैव टू राइट योर आंसर। Today we will discuss about transportation. Okay, transportation section is basically transportation. In this section, you will get mains question only from transportation of India, not from the world. Okay, but for a preliminary point of view, it is also important. Okay, so first we will discuss about the transportation of world, then we will enter in the transportation of India, and you can accept one or two questions from this section, okay, in mains. But it is important only for prelims. You have to focus only for prelims, but BJP government, contemporary government, is focusing more on infrastructure development, and this part is also included in your economic Indian economy section. So there is a chance the question will be from your GS third paper, okay? क्योंकि GS third paper में भी transportation है. So there is a chance you will get questions from that question in the third paper, not in the first paper, but still we have to discuss about that. Now so let's begin with the definition of transportation. Okay, what is transportation? Simple, transportation is a facility which enables us to move from one place to another, or it also help in the movement of goods. So transportation is basically, it is a facility, it is a facilities that provide us the movement, it is a facilities which help us in the movement of people from one place to another, and apart from that it also help in the movement of goods. Okay, so this is the simple definition of transportation. Now the mode of transportation, second is what? Mode of transportation. Transportation first is what do you mean by transportation? Simple definition, it is a facility which provides or which help in the movement of people as well as the goods from one place to another. Okay, second is mode of transportation. So we all know there are three mode of transportation. Okay, the first is land transportation. Okay, land transportation. Second is water transportation, water transportation, and third is air transportation. Okay, these are the three modes of transportation. Okay, now the first is land transportation. Land transportation, this transportation includes railways, roadways first, road transport, okay, rail transport, railways. Okay. Third is pipeline. This is very important for pre-examination. Okay. Pipelines. And fourth is ropeways. Ropeways. Okay. This is not very significant. So these are the transport types of transport under land transport. Okay. Roadways or road transport, rail transport, pipelines, and roadways. Now, the second is water transport is also of two types. Water transport. Okay. The first is oceanic transport. Okay. And second is inland transport. Inland waterways. Okay. Inland waterways. First is oceanic transportation or oceanic ways. Okay. And second is inland waterways. This is very important for mains also. But what I have said, this topic is also is in your GS paper third in economy section. So you can accept questions from transportation in that part third, in GS part third, not in geography. Okay. Now, so these are the, and air transportation is of two types. Domestic and international. Okay. Air transportation is of two types. Okay. Domestic transportation, domestic airways. Okay. And second is international airways. Okay. International airways. So these are the mode of transportation. Under land transportation, we will discuss about the road transportation and railway. Okay. Apart from that, pipeline is also very important. So let's begin with rail transportation. Okay. Railways. Okay, now look, the first railway, this rail transportation began in 1825. Okay, between Stockton and Darlington, it is in Northern England. Okay, rail transportation. It was begun in 1825 between Stockton and Darlington. Okay. And in Northern England. Okay. In Northern England. But in India, this railway was the first rail line was laid down, or the first railway. The first railway line was laid down in 1853. Okay. And the first rail or train ran on 16th April. This was the date you all have to learn that, keep in mind. On 16th April 1853, the first railway line was completed and the first rail or train ran on that. Okay. It was in between Bombay to Thane. Presently, it is called Mumbai to Thane. Mumbai to Thane. Okay. This was, the total distance was 34 kilometer. This was the first train of India. And Lord Dalhousie was the Governor General of India at that time. Okay. Now, in 1854, the second railway line was let down, or the operation of railway started in between Kolkata and Raniganj. Okay, in between Kolkata and Raniganj. And this was 180 kilometer. Okay, so this was the beginning of railway in India. So first railway line was, or we can say that the first operation of railway took place in 1825, and in between Stockton and Darlington, it is in northern England. And in India, the first operation of railway was took place on 16th April 1853 between Mumbai to Thane. This was 34 kilometer, and the next year the operation of railway began between Kolkata and Raniganj. It was 180 kilometer, and this was the beginning of the railway, first in European countries and then in India. Now the speed of train is depend upon gauge. Gauge means the distance between two tracks. Okay, the distance between two tracks, and the speed of train is depend upon this gauge system. Okay, now in different country, different gauge system is used. Gauge is what? It is a distance between tracks. Okay, and this distance determine the speed of train. Okay, now look here. Generally, first we will discuss about the world. Okay, and almost entire world follow a similar pattern. Okay, this gauge is of different types. Gauge is divided into different categories. Okay, what is gauge? It is a distance between the tracks, and the gauge determine the speed of train. Okay, and this gauge is of different kind in different country. Different country adopted different type of gauge. Okay, first I am discussing about the world, and then we will discuss about the India. Okay, India gauge. Now generally in world, first is broad gauge, and the distance between the track is more than 1.5 meter. More than the distance between the track is more than 1.5 meter. This is called broad gauge. Okay. Second is standard gauge. Okay. In this standard gauge, the distance between two track is 1.44 meter. These things you have to learn. And this standard gauge is used by UK. Okay, this is gauge is basically the UK train of UK is run on standard gauge. And this is also followed by the different country. Third is meter gauge. Okay, meter gauge. In meter gauge, the distance is 1 meter. Okay, and the second is, and the fourth is a smaller gauge. A smaller gauge, less than one meter. Okay, so these are the standard gauge. These are the gauge used in the entire world. But in India, we have broad gauge, meter gauge, narrow gauge. Okay, in India, broad gauge. Okay, in India there is a broad gauge. Yes, this is broad gauge, and the distance between track is 1.676 meter. This is for India. okay, the broad gauge, the distance between the track is 1.676 meter, okay, and 86% of railway, 86% of Indian railway is under broad gauge. Remember this point, okay, 86% of Indian railways is under broad gauge. And what is the distance in broad gauge between tracks? 1.676 meter. Okay. Second is meter gauge. Meter gauge. Okay. It is of 1 meter. The distance between track is 1 meter. And only 9.82% of Indian railway is under meter gauge. Okay. And only in some part of India. And third is narrow gauge. Third is what? Narrow gauge. Okay. In narrow gauge, we use two types of gauge. The distance is 0.762 meter or 0.610 meter. These are the two dimensions. These are the two measurements we use in narrow gauge. Okay. These are the two measurements we use in narrow gauge, 0.762 meter and second is or 0.610 meter. Okay. And generally toy trains, we will discuss about that. Toy trains from Simla to Kalka to Simla or Darjeeling train, Darjeeling or Matheran, we will get such type of tracks. Okay. We are discussing about the railways. Okay. And the distance of and the speed of railway is determined by gauge. What is gauge? Gauge is the distance between two tracks. Do tracks hote hain na railway ke, do tracks hote hain. To usi ko kya kaha jata hai? The distance between two tracks is called gauge. Okay. Now, the gauge is used, different country use different type of gauges. First, so I have made here differentiation. First is, this is for world. Generally, European countries use this system of gauge. In what is the meaning of gauge? It is the distance between the tracks. And the speed of train is depend upon this gauge. Now, the gauge which is used by the European nation is four types. Broad gauge, the distance between track is 1.5 meter. Standard gauge, 1.44 meter. Meter gauge, 1 meter. A smaller gauge, less than 1 meter. In India, three types of gauges are used. Okay. First is broad gauge, the distance between the tracks is 1.676 meter. And 86% of Indian rail is under broad gauge. Okay, we are converting, we are changing all the gauges into broad gauge. Because what I have said, the speed of train is determined by the tracks. Or tracks means what? The gauge. If train will run on meter gauge, the speed will be very less. And if the train will run on narrow gauge, the speed will be lesser than meter gauge. So 86% of Indian railway is under broad gauge, means the distance between the track is 1.676 meter. Only 9.82% of India's railway is under meter gauge. The distance between track is 1 meter. And narrow gauge is, we use two type of narrow gauge, 0.762 meter and 0.610 meter. Okay. This narrow gauge is used in hilly areas, because in hilly areas, it is the train basically does not run in a linear pattern, in linear pattern, not running a straight line. Okay. It moves in zigzag form. So it is very difficult to increase the kya karna uska speed ko increase karna. That's why narrow gauge is used in where? In the hilly areas. What is gauge? It is simply the distance between the tracks. Okay. I hope it is clear to all of you. Is it clear of clear to all of you? So this is used by the European nation. This is used by the India. This is used. This gas system is used by India. Okay. And we are converting with a great speed to all meter narrow gauge into broad gauge, except narrow gauge, because the length of narrow gauge is very less, only 4,000 kilometer. 4,000 se bhi kam hai. And only in hilly areas. When we discuss about the toy train, Kalka, there is a toy train, Matheran, Nilgiri train, Darjeeling train. These are very beautiful trains. Aap utar ke bhi chal sakte ho, track par chalte hue bahut dheere dheere chalti hai train ye sab. So these trains are run on narrow gauge. Now the next is transcontinental railway. I am discussing about the first of all the railways of the world, then we will discuss about the India. Okay, next is transcontinental railways. Transcontinental railways. Okay, now look here. Transcontinental railways are those railway which connects the two ends of continent. Suppose this is continent, okay, and if railway connects the two ends like this or like this, okay, this is called transcontinental railway. Okay, the transcontinental railways are those railways that connects the or run across the connects the transcontinental railways are those railway which connects the two ends of, okay, connects two ends of continent, ends of continent, okay, or we can say run across the continent, okay, or we can say transcontinental railways are those railway which runs across, okay, which run across the continent. Okay, this transcontinental railways are constructed due to two reasons. Okay, constructed due to two reasons. First is economic and political. Okay, economic reason was there why these railways were constructed, why transcontinental railway is constructed, is due to two reason: economic reason and second is political reason. We will discuss about political reason. There are two reasons behind that. But now these days transcontinental railways are losing its importance. Transcontinental railways are losing their importance, and the reason is the faster availability of fast mode of transportation like air transportation and road transportation. Okay, this transcontinental railways are losing its importance, and the reason is the development of faster means of transportation like airplane and road transportation. Okay, so I hope it is clear what is transcontinental railway. Now I am going to discuss some important transcontinental railway. Okay, now I am going to discuss some important transcontinental railway. What is transcontinental railway? The railway that joins the two ends of continent, okay, or run across the continent. Okay, these railways are let down or constructed due to two reasons. Economic reason was there, and some we will discuss how political reason was responsible. Okay, and now these days the transcontinental railways are kya hai? Not very important. Okay, because the reason is the development of faster mode of transportation like roadways and air transportation. Now the first is ट्रांस साइबेरियन रेलवे, ट्रांस साइबेरियन रेलवे, ओके. द फर्स्ट रेलवे इज ट्रांस साइबेरियन. दिस इज द फर्स्ट कॉन्टिनेंटल रेलवे. वी कैन से दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ट्रांस कॉन्टिनेंटल रेलवे एंड अंडर दैट ट्रांस कॉन्टिनेंटल वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, वी आर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ट्रांस साइबेरियन रेलवे. ओके, नाउ लुक हियर, दिस ट्रांस साइबेरियन रेलवे, द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ दिस वॉज स्टार्टेड इन 1891. It is the Trans Siberian Railway is the railway of Russia. Railway of Russia. Okay, railway of Russia. The construction of this railway was started in 1891 and completed in 1905. Okay. The total length of this railway is 9332 kilometer. What is the total length? 9332 kilometer. Okay, it is a double tracked. Okay, double tracked. Double track hai and electrified. Okay, double tracked and electrified transcontinental railway. Okay, look. This is Russia. Suppose I will show the map. Okay, and this is what Pacific Ocean. Pacific Ocean, and this part is the European Russia, and this part is Asian Russia. This is what, this is European Russia, the most developed part of Russia, European Russia. And this is Asian Russia. Asian Russia. Okay. Now it runs like that. Okay. It connects. Isko connect karta hai? Saint Petersburg. This is what? Saint Petersburg. Saint Petersburg in the west to Vladivostok. In the east, okay, it connects Saint Petersburg and Vladivostok. Okay, Vladivostok. Vladivostok on the eastern Pacific coast. Okay, Vladivostok in on the it connects. Saint Petersburg in the west to the Vladivostok in the where on the Pacific coast, means it connects the Asian part of Russia and European part of Russia. Okay, now look here, I am going to discuss some of the major station of this Trans-Siberian Railway, which is very important. Once UPSC has asked, okay. Now, look here, Moscow. Okay, Moscow is there. Okay, apart from that, Moscow, Ufa is there. Okay, Ufa. Ufa is okay. Look here. This is what, this is your map of Russia. This is Saint Petersburg. Okay, this is Saint Petersburg. Okay, and Wait. Look. This is St. Petersburg. Okay. From here, it comes to Moscow. Here is Ufa. This is what? Here is Moscow. Okay. Then it comes Ufa. Okay. Oh my God. This is what? St. Petersburg, then Moscow, then Ufa. Okay. And you will get, after that Ufa, you will get Novosibirsk. Novosibirsk. Okay. Then you will get Irkutsk. This is Irkutsk. Okay. Then this is Chita. Okay. Chita. And after Chita, you will get one other station. Here is what? Here you will get Vladivostok. Okay. Here you will get Vladivostok. So these are the areas from St. Petersburg to Moscow. Then Moscow, Ufa is important. Then Novosibirsk. Then Irkutsk. Then Chita. And then Vladivostok. Okay. So these are the major railway stations on this Trans-Siberian Railway. Two stations are very important. Okay. Two stations are very important. Chita and Irkutsk. Chita. Okay. Chita. Chita is very important. Why? It is the famous agro. It is famous for agricultural center. It is famous for agro center. Okay. It is famous for it is a agro center. Chita is famous for agriculture market. Okay. And second is Irkutsk. Irkutsk. Okay. Irkutsk. It is fur center. Okay. It is fur center, which is used to make sweaters and shawls and other things. Okay. Now, this region is basically this Siberian, Trans-Siberian Railway was constructed to connect. Look here, I'm just making a, this is what, this is, here is, this is the railway line. Okay. Now, this is St. Petersburg and this is Vladivostok. Now, this railway line was constructed to connect the central industrial region of the, okay, this is what, this is Ural region. This is what? Ural region. This Ural region is very famous for mineral. Okay. And apart from that, it is also famous for iron and steel industry. Steel industry. Ural region. Okay. Ural region. Siberia region. Okay, this entire region is what? This region is what? Siberia region. Okay, this Siberia region is famous for forest. Okay. Apart from that, this region is also very rich in natural gas and petroleum. And apart from that, other minerals are also found. So the purpose of this development was, the purpose of the development of this railway was to connect all these area to the main part of Russia. Okay. European part of, this is the main part of Russia. This is the Asian part of Russia. Asian part of Russia is not developed because this is Siberian region and entire Siberian region is covered with ice. But this region is very, very rich in minerals and other resources. Okay. That's why the Russian government, former government of Russia, USSR, it was constructed. वैसे यूएसएसआर 1970 में बना, रशियन गवर्नमेंट कंस्ट्रक्टेड दिस रेलवे, ओके, ओनली टू फैसिलिटेट द मूवमेंट ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल्स एंड मिनरल्स एंड टू कनेक्ट द इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन ऑफ यूराल रीजन एंड द फॉरेस्ट रीजन ऑफ साइबेरिया एंड अदर पार्ट ऑफ रशिया. So this was the first railway. First, क्या लिखा हम लोगों ने, क्या पढ़ा, ट्रांस साइबेरियन रेलवे. ओके, नाउ वी विल मूव टू अनदर रेलवे. ओके, ट्रांस कैनेडियन रेलवे. आयरन एंड स्टील. ओके, फॉरेस्ट, साइबेरियन रीजन इज ऑल्सो वेरी फेमस फॉर the forest of softwood which is used, sort of softwood is used in paper industry. Okay, and 45% of softwood is found in Russia. So 45% of softwood of the entire world is found in Russia. So this Siberian region is very rich in minerals, apart from minerals, and in minerals it is very rich in petroleum and natural gas. Apart from that, Siberian region is also rich in coniferous forest or the forest of polar region, which are used in paper industry. Okay, so this is your first Trans-Siberian railway, connects two ends, the major railway stations. Okay, and the length is 9332 kilometer. Okay, two stations, Chita and Irkutsk, very famous. Chita is for agro, it is agro center, and second is Irkutsk is the first center. Okay, now the next is Trans-Canadian Railway. Okay, Trans-Canadian Railway. Look here. Trans-Canadian Railway Look, this is your Canada. Okay, Trans-Canadian Railway is the railway that joins the Vancouver, okay, Vancouver on the Pacific. This is what? Pacific Ocean. Okay, Vancouver. Okay, this is Winnipeg. Okay, and here it comes to Halifax. Okay, this is Halifax. Okay, this is Atlantic Ocean. So it connects Vancouver on the Pacific coast to the Halifax. Halifax is in Nova Scotia. It is on this area is Nova Scotia. Okay, Nova Scotia. Halifax and Nova Scotia. Halifax in Nova Scotia. Okay, now look here. This Trans-Canada Railway is about 7050 kilometer in length. Okay, and the main reason behind the construction of this railway was political. Iska main reason kya tha? Political reason tha. Okay, look here. Why? What was the political reason? This area is British Columbia. This is what? British Columbia. British Columbia. This part is British Columbian state of British Columbian state of Canada. Okay, now British Columbia, there is an agreement signed, okay, in 1881. Agreement was signed between British Columbia and other part of Canada, and in that agreement British Columbia said kya kaha tha ki British Columbia would join main Canada only if its western part is connected to the eastern part. कि जब तभी ये वेस्टर्न कोलंबिया स्टेट कनाडा का पार्ट तभी होगा. इट विल बी द पार्ट ऑफ कैनेडियन फेडरेशन ओनली व्हेन द वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ दिस ब्रिटिश कोलंबिया को किससे ज्वाइन करेंगे? कनेक्टेड टू द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ कनाडा. सो दिस वाज द एग्रीमेंट which was signed in 1881 and finally completed. This railway line was completed in 1886. So it was constructed due to agreement between British Columbia and the rest part of Canada. And the what was the reason? To connect the western part of British Columbia in the main part of Canada. Warna Canada kehta ki hum alag ho jayenge, hum alag hi rahenge. Ye कौन सा? ब्रिटिश कोलंबिया. सो देयर वाज एन एग्रीमेंट. ओके, एग्रीमेंट ज्वाइन द फेडरेशन ऑफ स्टेट्स. ओके, सो इट वाज कंस्ट्रक्टेड ड्यू टू कैनेडियन रेलवे. ट्रांस कैनेडियन रेलवे कनेक्ट्स वैंकूवर on the western coast, Vancouver on the Pacific coast. It is on western coast of Canada. It connects Vancouver in the west to the Halifax in the east, and Halifax on the Atlantic coast, and Vancouver is on the Pacific coast. Is it clear? What is the length? 7050 kilometer. Okay, what is the reason behind the construction of development of this railway? Agreement kiske beech? British Columbia and the rest part of Canada. And agreement was signed in 1881, and in that agreement it was clearly mentioned that British Columbia would join the Federation of Canada on one condition kya tha? To connect the western end of British Columbia to the eastern part of Canada, because this part of Canada is very developed. Got my points or not? Point samajh mein aaya? So political reason was involved, but after that its significance of this increased. Got my point? it was constructed due to political reason. But after that, the economic significance of this railway increased tremendously. Why increased? Because look, this is Winnipeg. Winnipeg is known as the wheat market of the world. Okay, it is called the wheat market of the world. It is in the prairie region. It is in the prairie region. Okay, prairie region of grassland. Prairie region is very famous for. अभी तो बताया Canada is a federation. We all know what is federation. Okay, what is federation? I think you all have that in political Indian polity, federation. And our federal system is based on Canada. We all know. So British Columbia was not ready to join this federation earlier. So there was an agreement was signed between British Columbia and the rest of Canada, Federation of Canada. The purpose was to connect Trans-Siberian, na? Okay. The purpose was to connect the Asian part of Russia to the European part of Russia. Okay, uska wahi reason tha to connect the what was the reason behind the construction of Trans-Siberia was to connect the eastern part of Russia to the or Asian part of Russia to the European part of Russia. And Asian part of Russia is very rich in natural resource. Now, this is the Canadian Railway. Okay. Now, this is very important. Why? Look here. Winnipeg, the wheat market of the world, the largest market in the world. Okay. This is Quebec Montreal region. This is Quebec Montreal region. This region is very. This region is what? Industrial region of, very rich industrial region of Canada. Quebec Montreal region. Isko bhi kya kiya gaya? Correct kiya gaya. And apart from that, this northern region of Canada is also very rich in coniferous forest. Okay? Forest of softwood. So usko bhi kya karne ke liye? To connect. It is earlier it was constructed due to political reason, but its economic significance also increased. How increased? Winnipeg. It connects Winnipeg. Winnipeg is the world market. Okay, it is a world market of wheat. Apart from that, Quebec Montreal region, it is the most famous industrial region of Canada. It is also on this railway line. Apart from that, this northern part of Canada is also very rich in forest. Okay, or kinds of forest hai? Taiga and tundra forest, which is famous for softwood, and the softwood is used in paper industry. And we all know Canada is the largest producer of paper in the world. Okay, got my points? Now, there are two railways also. Canadian Pacific Railway. Okay? Canadian Pacific Railway. Canadian Pacific Railway. Okay? The other is Canadian Pacific Railway. It connects St. John's. Look here, this is St. John's. उसी को थोड़ा सा बढ़ा दिया गया है. This is St. John's. Okay, same line. Okay, St. John's to Vancouver. St. John's. यानी कि पहले कहां तक था? Halifax से था, but now it has extended to St. John's. St. John's is also on Nova Scotia. This is called Canadian Pacific Railway. Okay, it is the name of किसी का किसका नाम है? Trans-Siberia का ही नाम है ये. Okay. Earlier it was known as Trans-Siberia, but now it is known as Canadian Pacific Railway. But the length has increased. थोड़ा सा length बढ़ा दिया गया है. Earlier it was only to Halifax, but now it is up to St. John's. तो जो St. John's तक बढ़ाया गया है उसी का नाम क्या है? Canadian Pacific Railway. Okay. Now, Canadian National Railway. Another is Canadian National Railway. In Trans Canadian Railway, we found two other railways. Or in Canada, we found two other railways apart from Trans Canadian. First is Canadian Pacific Railway that connects Vancouver to the St. John's. Okay. Now, the next is Canadian National Railway that connects Halifax City and Prince Rupert. Okay. Prince Rupert is here. This is Prince Rupert. Prince Rupert. Okay. It connects Prince Rupert on the western coast and Halifax on the eastern coast. And the name of that railway is Canadian National Railway. Okay. Canadian National Railway. Okay. Now, next is the Union and Pacific Railway. The next railway is the Union and Pacific Railway. The Union and Pacific Railway. This railway is the railway of USA. कहाँ का है? Railway of USA का है. And it connects San Francisco. Okay, San Francisco on the western coast and New York on the eastern coast. This is New York. Okay, this is like this. This is called the Union and Pacific Railway. This railway is a part of USA. Okay, Union and Pacific Railway. The next is the Trans-Australian Railway. Okay. The next is Trans-Australian Railway. Okay. Trans-Australian Railway. The next is Trans-Australian Railway. Okay. Look here. This Trans-Australian Railway connects. This is Perth. This is Perth on the western coast. It is on the Indian Ocean. And it runs through that. And Sydney on the Pacific coast. Okay. This was also constructed due to political reason. Why? Because Western Australia, the biggest province of Australia, was not ready to join the Australian Federation. And finally, agreement was signed. And what happened? This railway was constructed. Okay. So this is Perth on the western side and Sydney on the eastern side. This is also very famous transcontinental railway. Okay. And two important center, Kalgoorlie. Look here, Kalgoorlie. This is Kalgoorlie. Okay. And very near to Kalgoorlie, there was Coolgardie. Okay. Coolgardie. It is not mentioned here. ओके कुल गार्डी, कालगुरली एंड कुल गार्डी, दीज आर द टू मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सेंटर एंड दीज टू इंपॉर्टेंट सेंटर्स आर किसके लिए फेमस है, फॉर गोल्ड, वेस्टर्न ऑस्ट्रेलिया में है. कालगुरली एंड कुल गार्डी आर द टू मोस्ट फेमस गोल्ड माइंस ऑफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया. इट इज नॉट ओनली फेमस इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया बट ऑल्सो इन द इंटायर वर्ल्ड. ओके एंड दीज लाइन्स, दीज टू गोल्ड माइंस आर लोकेटेड ऑन दिस रेलवे लाइन, ट्रांस ऑस्ट्रेलियन रेलवे. Got my points? Okay. Now, the next is, this is only important for pre-examination. Apart from that, one line is also very important. Okay. Broken Hill. Broken Hill of Australia is also on this line, on this railway track. And it is famous for, Broken Hill is famous for minerals. ओके वो मैं बता दूंगा आप लोग को. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज, द नेक्स्ट इज द ओरिएंट एक्सप्रेस, द ओरिएंट एक्सप्रेस, ओरिएंट. ओके द नेक्स्ट इज ओरिएंट एक्सप्रेस, ओरिएंट एक्सप्रेस फ्रॉम पेरिस टू इस्तांबुल. टर्की. ओके तो दिस इज व्हाट, पेरिस टू टर्की, ट्रांस सॉरी द ओरिएंट एक्सप्रेस इज फ्रॉम, रन्स फ्रॉम पेरिस टू इस्तांबुल इन टर्की. ओके Now, the next is Trans-Andean Railway. The next is Trans-Andean Railway. Okay, Trans-Andean Railway. Okay. Trans-Andean Railway. Look, this is South America. So, Trans-Andean Railway. Andean means what? This is, this is Andes. Okay? This is what? Andes Mountain. Okay? Now, Buenos Aires is the capital of Argentina. Okay, so this is what, Buenos Aires, and this is Valparaiso of Chile. So this railway line, Trans-Andean railway line, runs between Buenos Aires and Valparaiso. Valparaiso is in Chile, one of the most dangerous railway line in the world because it passes through the Andes Mountain. Okay, so and it is passing through Usfalta Pass. Okay, it is passing through Usfalta. Okay, Usfalta Pass and connects Buenos Aires with Valparaiso. Valparaiso is in Chile and Buenos Aires is the capital of Argentina. Okay, the most dangerous railway line in the world. Okay, because it passes through the Andes Mountain, the longest mountain chain in the world. सबसे लंबा है. Okay, now the next is The next is Vayu. Okay. Vayu, London railway line. Railway. This is in China. This is in China. And this is in UK. This line is 12,000 kilometer long. Okay. And it is the longest. It is the longest freight railway. Freight railway means only carry it only carry goods. Longest freight railway in the world. Second, not it is not longest. It is the second longest. Okay, and it was in 2017. This railway line was let down in 2017. Kab start kiya gaya isko? In 2017. Okay, and look here. It is the second largest, second longest. The longest is in between you and Madrid. You and Madrid in 2014. So these are the important railway line, and this length is 12,800 kilometer around. So there is no need to learn the length. Okay, so these are the two longest rail line. But remember one thing, it is only these two lines are only the freight rail lines, means only the goods are carried on this line, not the passenger trains run on this line. Okay, so these are the important rail lines of the world. Okay, these are the important. So you all have to learn only for the preliminary point of view, not for the mains. Okay, I will also provide the notes of this entire whatever we have discussed today. Okay, now the next is roadways. Okay, first is major highway in the world. Roadways, today I am only discuss about the world. Okay, world roadways, world railways, world that inland waterways. Okay, tomorrow or day after tomorrow I will discuss thoroughly about the Indian transport system. Okay, now roadways. Okay, roadways of the world. The first is Trans-Canadian Highway. The first is, the most important is Trans-Canadian. Canadian Highway. Trans-Canadian. So it also connects the two ends of. Okay. It is the most important. Okay. Highway in the world. It connects St. John City. Look, this is Canada. Here is St. John's. St. John City. Of Newfoundland. Newfoundland. St. John's. Thoda sa alag ho gaya ye. This is St. John's. Okay. And Vancouver. So it connects the eastern and western part of Canada. Okay, So this is what? This is your first Trans-Canadian Highway connects. Okay, the total length is 9,600 kilometer. It is 9,600 kilometer in length. Okay, now second is Alaskan Highway. Second is Alaskan. Okay, we all know this part is called Alaska. Okay, this part is called Alaska. Okay, this is Canada and this is USA. Okay, Alaska is the part of USA. Kiska part hai? It is a part of, okay, and it connects Anchorage. Anchorage is a city in Alaska. Okay, Anchorage. TH Anchorage, city of Anchorage to Edmonton. Edmonton is, it is in Canada. Okay, Edmonton. These two cities are connected by a highway called Alaskan Highway. Okay, Alaska is a part of USA. Okay, and Anchorage is here, and second is what? Edmonton is in Canada. So this railway line, this roadways connects the two cities of USA and Canada. Next is Stuart Highway. Next is Stuart Highway. Okay. Stuart Highway. Look here. It is a highway of Australia. Okay. And Highway of Australia is known as Commonwealth Road. Commonwealth Road. Look here. Just like that. Just like in India, we have National Highway. Okay. So in Canada, the national highways are called Commonwealth Road. Okay. So Stuart Highway is one of the most important highway of Australia, and it connects the east, north and south. Okay. South. Okay. In north. Okay. Birdum City, okay, B-I-R-D-U-M, Birdum City, in North Australia, to Melbourne, okay, in the Southern Australia, okay, Melbourne, in South Australia. In South Australia. So it is north south. It connects the northern end and southern end of Australia. Okay. So this is what important, some important roadways in the world. Okay. There are also some important, but roadways also. But not very important, but that will be written in your notes. वो सब क्या है? Notes में लिखा हुआ है. उसमें देख लीजिएगा. Just you have to learn the name of two ends of the road. Okay, दो तीन और हैं. Okay, so these are the important railways of the world, railway line in the world, and second is important roadways in the world. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss the inland waterways like Panama Canal, Suez Canal and other canals. Okay, and then we will move towards India. Okay, Indian transport system, we will discuss that elaborately. Usko hum log kya karenge? Achche se discuss karenge. Okay, so this is not important for mains. It is only important for your preliminary examination. Mark all these points on your map, atlas. Okay, just mark that point. Dono ko points mark karo where it is located. Significant of that reason, just only you have to learn. Okay, not important for means. Okay, I am saying. Okay, but in India we will discuss some points which are important for means, but it will not come. It will not be a part of your geography, but definitely वो किसका part होगा? Indian economy का part होगा. Okay? So today I am going to wind up this class. Thank you. Okay? Thank you very much.